Hi there. Let's learn how to change audio volume today. Using audio and video, there is a high chance that you will need increase or decrease there the sound level sometimes. Knowing that, ActivePresenter makes the volume adjustment a quick and easy task for you. Note that a video object also has the object time bar in the timeline. You can adjust it as a normal audio object. You can change the audio volume for an audio part or for the whole audio track. Before we start, you should increase the waveform bar height, making it easier for you to see the change of the sound level. Right-click the audio time bar. Click waveform bar height. And select medium or large. Now, to change the volume for an audio part, you have to define the audio range first. Just drag the green and yellow marker along the timeline ruler to select the range. Then, click the adjust volume button to open the volume scaling dialog. This is a relative volume scale, with a default value of 100%, which is the original volume. You can adjust it from 0, means mute, to 500%, means original volume 10.5. Besides, to quickly silence the track, click mute. After that, you will see the changes of the waveform bar. These two red verticals indicate the changed range. Let's preview the change. Changing the sound level for the whole audio track is similar to doing that for a specific part of the track. However, you don't have to define the audio range. Just select the audio file and do the same as before. After all the changes and adjustments of the audio tracks, you can definitely go back to their original volume. Similar to changing the sound level, you can restore the sound level for any specific part of the audio or the whole track at once. To restore the original volume of an audio part, you should make sure that the snap mode is turned on. This helps you select the range more easily. Just click Timeline Snapping in the View tab. Then, select the audio range. Drag the green and yellow marker to the two red vertical markers. As you can see, when the marker of the playhead comes in the vicinity of the red vertical line, it will make a tiny jump to match the edge of each other. Click the drop-down arrow on the Adjust Volume button. And then click Restore Original Volume. Regardless of where you change volume, you can restore the audio track as a whole. Just select the track and take the same steps as before. That's all about changing the audio volume in ActivePresenter 7. Thank you for watching.